Curious about where to get started with your smart home? Today I'm going to share some solid advice that should get your smart home up and running in part one of this multi-part Getting Started series. Today's topic, the Smart Home Hub. Stay tuned. Hi again, John Stone, the DIY Smart Home Guy. I've been getting a lot of questions about how or where to start with your smart home. So today I'm going to share my personal advice for getting started. I'll also share some insights about how to keep from ticking off your spouse in the process. Guys, let's face it, we mean well. We see this new piece of tech and we want it in our home, so you tell yourself,
"Self, my wife is going to be so happy when all this is done."
So you go out and you buy all these sexy new gadgets. Dude, you might as well have brought a new girlfriend into the house. And your wife, girlfriend, whoever, isn't as excited as you'd hope. You hear the mumbles and you just can't seem to understand why this new mystical palace that you've created isn't received with the same enthusiasm that you had imagined. Well, here's the deal. You didn't have a plan. Well, not a good one at least. So let me help get you back on track. I can tell you from experience that the biggest problem anyone other than you will have in your smart home is ease of use. And I don't mean ease of use for you, I mean ease of use for everyone but you. Yeah, I know, it's super cool and you can control the lights with your phone and you can use your voice to raise and lower the temperature, big deal. It's not as cool as you think. What's cooler is never needing to control anything, and if you do, feeling comfortable knowing that decades of turning lights on and off manually will work in the same way.
In spite of this trap, your mission, should you choose to accept it,
is not to take anything away from the existing home experience. All right, here's the plan. As I said, this is a multi-part video series. As more videos get added, I'll add links in the description below, and you'll find affiliate links to useful products mentioned in this video. At the end of the video, I'll link up to the next video in the series after it becomes available. So the first thing you're going to need is a real smart home hub. Two great hubs out there are the Samsung SmartThings and the Wink Hub 2. There are other great hubs, but these are the most popular and the easiest to get started with. Since you're starting out and you don't know where to start, starting here is a solid plan. And before you send me the inevitable question, which one is better?
Don't do it.
I'll directly compare the Wink Hub 2 with the SmartThings Hub in a future video. Both Wink and SmartThings have their advantages and disadvantages. Wink has an additional radio that allows you to control Lutron and kid devices. If you want or need Lutron dimmers, SmartThing doesn't natively support them at the time I created this video. Issues like these could be important when you're trying to create your automation programs. On the other hand, SmartThings does offer better device automation programming options, and SmartThing has a built-in battery backup. Wink falls a bit behind in this area. If you're an Apple fan, there's HomeKit. Right now, there's limited device support for HomeKit, but I think that's going to change this year. My advice, pick a hub, any hub, and build your plan around that hub. With very few exceptions, either hub will work for you as long as you stay within the device range that the hub supports.
Do I really even need a hub? I mean, can't I just piece things together with IFTTT, Amazon Echo, Google Home, whatever other things I can?
Yeah, you can, but take a look at this. A smart home consists of devices that you place in and around your home. These include things like lights, alarms, sensors, thermostats, cameras, and a whole bunch of other cool gadgets. Many manufacturers will have their own hubs, which is true for Logitech, Philips, Lightify, Lutron, and a host of other products. But these hubs are specifically designed for their own products. While they may support other devices in a very limited practice, they will always fall short in controlling whole home automation. And because they're smart, you'll need a way to control them. Controlling these devices is performed through apps on mobile devices or computers, or you can use your voice if you want to integrate with the Echo. And you should be able to control devices manually if you're not using schedules and routines. And routines are basically like little programs that you create to make things happen based on other events. So you still don't need a hub at this point, or do you? If you choose to go the hubless route and you want a truly smart home, every device you select must have an app that integrates with IFTTT and or the Echo or the Google Home. And you're counting on that integration to provide all of the functions you're looking for. If you want to integrate all your devices together in a very useful way, you'll need a real smart home hub. Some apps allow you to create schedules, but only for their devices. And by the way, a majority of the lighting products require a real smart home hub. My opinion is, you'll ultimately decide that you need a smart home hub, even if you don't think you need one right now. So, pick a hub, a powerful hub, and a hub that's user-friendly. And by the way, the Echo is not a hub. IFTTT is not a hub. While they do offer some hub-like benefits, they're still not a hub. The point? Get a hub. Now that we've settled on that, what's next? So the plan. If we look at five categories of things that comprise a smart home, it should make it easier for you to establish your smart home plan. My five categories include lighting devices, environmental devices, energy devices, security devices, and entertainment devices. But when you really think about it, device types can play multiple roles. For example, lights can serve more than their utilitarian purpose and contribute to environmental comfort as well as energy savings. A thermostat can contribute more as well. It can also be a part of your energy savings plan. So you can see that device interaction is a key element, which again supports the need for a real smart home hub. As you can see from the diagram, lighting is related to everything. So that's point number two. Start with lighting. My next video will be an overview of how to start with lighting. However, in the description below, you will find links to several videos that talk about various lighting options, including light bulbs, light strips, in-wall switches, and plug-in modules. These should help get you started while you wait for the next video. So to recap, start with the hub, whether you plan to use voice control or not. Starting with lighting is a safe bet. Don't sacrifice manual control for the sake of cool. If the first thing you think about is how other people in your house will use the new technology, you will turn them into smart home believers. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and don't forget to click like. Over here are a couple of other videos that you might enjoy. For more reviews, tips, and DIY videos, visit azhb.com. And thanks to you that are already following me over on Facebook or Twitter, both are at DIY Smart Home Guy. Until next time, cheers.